atmosphere at 93.8% optimal. At least we won't suffocate soon.
Mm-hmm.
24.1 degrees Celsius. I knew it was getting warm in here. I don't like the looks of this hull integrity indicator.
We don't like the looks of anything around here. Let's go inside. Missed part of it.
Captain, I've got bad news for you. This rift is affecting the hull of the ship. Our hull integrity is dropping fast.
How bad is this, Scotty?
It's at 92% and dropping rapidly. According to our system specs, if it drops below 63%...
Put as much powers as you can to the shields. Use them to support our hull integrity.
Hmm, sounds like a good idea.
Divert as much power as you can to the sensors. Let's find out what's causing this.
Doesn't seem like such a good idea.
Evacuate all people from the outer decks. Divert power from life support on those decks evenly to shields and sensors.
Hmm, kind of like that.
Divert as much power as you can. Evacuate all people from the outer decks. Divert power from life support on those decks evenly to shields and sensors.
Hope this won't restrict where we haven't gone yet.
Captain, that'll only add about 2% to the shields and sensors.
Do it, Mr. Scott.
Aye, Captain.
I hope that's a good idea. All right, let's look around.
The impulse engines of the USS Enterprise. Looking at them reminds you of several times they threatened to break down. Now the engines are running fine. It's the other sections of the Enterprise that are breaking down.
Interesting.
This seems pointless. Impulse engine fuel control systems. This system monitors fuel usage in the impulse engines.
Hmm, cool.
Impulse engine deflector control grid. This system prevents the Enterprise from being pulverized at near light speed by micrometeorites.
Sounds like a good thing.
Life support control systems. This monitors and controls the ship's life support.
Hmm.
This seems pointless.
Light.
This seems pointless. This seems pointless.
What are these little things?
Impulse engine fuel. This seems pointless.
Okay, have we looked at everything then?
Life support. Mr. Scott is wondering how Kirk's adventures are going to affect his poor engines this time.
Hey, this is all our adventure now.
James Kirk, captain of the Enterprise, professional crisis manager.
Right.
Hikaru Sulu, capable helmsman of the Enterprise, expert physicist, and a natural leader. Certainly, he's destined to become a Starfleet captain.
Yes, and he does have a captain his own ship one day. I believe we saw that in one of the movies. Not sure which one. Maybe it was Generations?
Pavel Chekhov, a young and somewhat impetuous navigator, likely to mature into a seasoned officer.
Hmm. The futures of all these people if we survive this mission.
Angus Walker, an experienced security officer who's seen many strange things on the Enterprise. His memoirs will be very interesting.
So you have much of a future? All these people are going and you just talk about his memoirs.
Well, here we are. The ship is literally falling apart. Space could explode randomly at any moment and destroy the Enterprise. And Spock has been kidnapped by the aliens.
Aye, a typical day on the Enterprise.
I was gonna say that, just another day, huh?
Captain, surely you must have a plan.
Of course I do. I just need to find out what it is, that's all.
Oh, that's very reassuring, Captain.
Yeah, don't mind me. I'll just pull it out of my ass.
You know, it just wouldn't be the Enterprise without a crisis.
Sometimes I wish space were a little more predictable than it is.
Hmm.
Mr. Scott looks a bit more frazzled than usual, Captain.
Well, what do you expect, man? I'm not a miracle worker. There's only so much a person can do.
That's right.
Captain, is it too late to put in a request for an early retirement?
Scotty, if we hit any more of these random detonations, it'll be mandatory retirement for all of us.
Actually, Captain, I was hoping for a better pension.
Hmm. I'm sure you were.
Captain, we won't last 15 seconds in this dust storm without our deflector grid. If it's not broke, don't touch it.
Nah.
Laddie, do you know what you're doing? That's delicate equipment.
Nah.
Captain, the fuel control is working perfectly. Leave it alone!
I like the way he keeps yelling at us.
I think the engines are running just fine, Captain. The engines are running within acceptable parameters, Captain.
Good.
But, Captain, the controls are working just fine. The first rule of an engineer, if it ain't broke, don't fix it. But, Captain, Captain.
Okay, but, Captain. Okay, I guess we don't need to be doing anything in here, then. Next section. These are both engineering? What is all this then? I can't actually go there? These are working now. So yeah, let's check out auxiliary control and then transporter room, I guess.
Doorway to auxiliary control. Turbolift monitor. It says that the turbolift is on the auxiliary control deck.
I would hope so. That's where we left it.
This screen shows the layout on this deck. The door directly ahead of you leads to the auxiliary control. The deck integrity monitor. Nothing on this deck has been damaged yet.
Yeah, we'll fix that.
The doorway to the turbolift.
Lights.
This seems pointless.
Floor.
This seems pointless. Angus Walker wonders how they're going to remove the aliens this time.
This time? We haven't done it once yet.
Pavel Chekhov is a little nervous right now.
Are there aliens in there?
James Kirk wonders about his friend Spock's safety. Hikaru Sulu has seen more than one attempt by aliens to take control of the ship, and they've always failed.
Well, hopefully they'll fail this time as well.
Save new game. Replace pre-
Thoughts, gentlemen?
I could use advice. Suggestions, anyone? Spock.
Spock.
I know, Captain. We miss him too. Well, they say the price of freedom is eternal vigilance.
What does that mean, Sulu? That we should have been more vigilant? How could we?
Vigilant?
The sensor said nothing.
Well, maybe if Starfleet sensor designers would be quicker to modify their senses to react to new phenomena.
You two are as bad as Spock and McCoy.
Awaiting orders, Captain.
Almost as bad.
I'd feel more comfortable, Captain, if we knew what happened to Mr. Spock.
Alright.
Save new game. Replace pre-
Save over.
Our highest priority is control of the sensors. We must find Spock.
I'll handle it, Captain. Remember, I was a physicist when I first joined the Enterprise.
Ah!
Oh!
Captain, look!
Yep. So the reason I made that sound before, I was gonna sneeze, but I didn't.
A strange alien. This is the auxiliary control view screen.
This is the ship's auxiliary helm station. From here, the helmsman can control the ship's shields and its orbital heading.
This seems pointless.
And that's pointless.
This station is identical to the bridge's science station, allowing access to external sensors and the library computer. The dilithium crystal lattice monitor.
Okay.
Dilithium crystals are at 89% efficiency. This is below the optimum range, but still acceptable.
Cool.
This station is identical to the bridge's engineering control, allowing access to damage control systems and emergency power and internal sensors.
We'll just ignore this thing and look around some more.
A warp impulse energy efficiency diagram. The diagram shows that the warp engines are not currently active.
That's good, because it would be disastrous if we turn those on at this point.
The auxiliary control ventilation duct.
Ooh, ventilation duct.
This seems pointless.
Nasty looking thing.
You know, I wouldn't want that alien upset with me.
In my opinion, Captain,
It's the only way to save Spock and this ship.
But I know how to defend myself.
That's better.
Transporting away is the best defense.
So he really
you
says...
You know, I wouldn't want that alien upset with me.
In my opinion,
I'm going to have to teach you some more self-defense, Pavel.
But I know how to defend myself.
I wonder why they changed that.
I've seen a lot of life forms in my time, but I've never seen anything like that.
Actually, I thought it looked like a spike in Devonman.
No, the Devman has a much more curved back and much more distinct patterns on its skin.
They could be from the same evolutionary stock.
No, look at the way the second forearm juts from its thorax. They're not at all alike.
I'm sure this is fascinating, but right now, I have other concerns.
Gee, I wonder what that would be.
We don't have to hurt the alien, unless there's no other way to save the ship.
Hello, alien.
Captain. What happened?
It appears our alien friend likes its privacy.
Transported us.
The Cossacks have locked the door, Captain.
The Cossacks.
Deck layout screen. The deck integrity monitor says that everything is safe.
It could be a deception, Captain.
This says the turbo lift is on the auxiliary control level.
I wonder if anyone else would be better at this stuff. Well, I'm predicting we're gonna have to go to the transporter room and transport ourselves into that room. But at that point, what do we do?
I believe deck layouts bear a Russian invention. According to the deck integrity monitor, there are no systems malfunctions on this deck. The turbo lift is ready when needed, Captain.
Well, Captain, if we didn't know the way to auxiliary control, this deck layout could help us find it.
Very funny, sir.
Sorry, guys, just blowing my nose.
It's good to see that the ship hasn't entirely fallen apart.
I think that Mr. Scott would change the laws of physics before that happens.
And this?
The turbo lift is standing by, Captain.
I believe that...
We did that. The only other one we haven't tried is this guy.
I don't understand your orders, sir.
Mess with it, Ensign.
The deck integrity monitor says that everything is functioning here. Still, I wonder...
Out with it, Ensign.
The turbo lift is ready when we need it, sir.
I don't think we can shoot our way through. Or can we?
It appears the alien doesn't want us in auxiliary control, Captain.
If this continues, we won't be in auxiliary control or anywhere else.
All right, to the transporter room.
Captain, where would you like to be transported?
Send us to sickbay, Mr. Kyle. Send us to engineering, Mr. Kyle. Send us to auxiliary control, Mr. Kyle. We'll transport later, Mr. Kyle. Send us send us to auxiliary control, Mr. Kyle.
Yes, sir.
Everything okay, Mr. Kyle?
Energize.
It might just kill us now. We are nothing if not determined.
We don't have to hurt the alien.
Okay, so instead of trying to talk to it...
That's odd. All systems look normal. The aliens haven't touched the helm.
So what is it touching?
Everything seems to be working. Library computer, external sensors. I'd better use external sensors and see if we can find Spock. I wonder if there's a way to distract that alien so I can use the sensors to search for Spock.
The search for Spock.
I'd better use external sensors and see if I wonder if there's a way to distract that alien so I can use the sensors to search for Spock.
Distracting that thing is going to be a tall order, Captain.
Captain, we can't affect the dilithium monitor. It's only a readout of the lattice efficiency and stability.
I knew that, Mr. Sulu. What are we gonna do?
Everything
here
seems to be working except for internal sensors. I'd better put the sensors back online. Putting the sensors back online might provoke the alien. I'll leave it alone for now. Putting the sensors back online might provoke the alien.
I wonder why it doesn't want us to use the internal sensors.
Who knows?
Captain, the diagram cannot be adjusted except by changing the use of the warp and impulse engines.
Activate view screen.
The view screen functions are normal. The alien doesn't seem to have damaged anything.
Okay, well, before we do anything rash...
Save new game. Replace previous game.
Let's save, and then do something rash.
The Cossacks have locked the door, Captain.
What a bother. How can we distract it? Maybe Scotty has some ideas.
Captain, is it too late to put
Scotty if we hit it?
Actually, Captain.
Alright. Can't ask him about that.
Captain, we won't last 15 seconds in this. Laddie. Captain, the fuel controllers were. I think the engines are right.
How do we distract this guy? We haven't messed with any of the stuff in this hallway.
Captain, there are no problems with the sick bay doors.
Thank you.
Kirk to Scott. Come in, Scotty. Kirk to Uhura. Come in, Lieutenant. Kirk to Sick Bay. Bones, where are you?
Right on the other side of that door.
Computer. Kirk to Scott. Come in, Scotty. Computer.
Computer. I have no idea what to ask it.
Kirk to Scott. Kirk to Uhura. Come in, Lieutenant.
Captain, I've moved operations to Galileo 2 shuttlecraft. I've sent a message to Starfleet Command, and I've rerouted internal communications to run from here.
Lieutenant Uhura, what happens if the shuttle bay is hit by an explosion? That's one of the most vulnerable areas on the ship.
That's a risk I'm prepared to take, Mr. Sulu. I've activated the shuttle's shields for protection.
Good. Be prepared to evacuate the shuttle on my signal. Kirk out.
Okay, we're gonna mess with the shuttle, apparently.
We don't have time to waste.
Not again.
Jim, we've got to get out of here.
We need to get Spock back.
I should have known the Spock would be good for something someday. Now the day has come, and he isn't here. Jim, what is going on out there?
Spock is gone, Bones. He was transporting off the bridge, and then he vanished, and then this alien appeared in auxiliary control.
An alien kidnapped Spock? Why?
I don't know, Bones.
Jim, I'll need a medical scan of the alien if I'm to do anything.
Well, that means you have to come with us.
Jim, I'm waiting for that medical scan.
We're trying.
Okay, but right here, why are you speaking through the intercom at us?
Well, Bones, it looks like we have to save Spock in order...
That's a tough choice.
Alright, so we need to scan the alien. And or get to the shuttle. Let's... scan the alien. Transporter room.
Captain, where would you like to be transported?
Send us to sick bay. Send us to engineering, Mr. Cobb. Send us to auxiliary control.
Yes, sir.
I guess he knows the aliens
in there.
That's
not Captain. The transporter will not lock on any coordinates in auxiliary control, and I have no idea why.
Send us to sickbay, Mr. Kyle.
Oh, that's no good.
Send us to engineering. Send us to auxiliary control, Mr. Kyle. We'll transport later. Send us to auxiliary...
Yes, sir. That's odd, Captain. The transporter will not lock on...
Send us to sickbay, Mr. Kyle. We'll transport later. Send us to auxiliary... Send us to engineering, Mr. Kyle.
I guess...
Send us to auxiliary. We'll transport later.
Transport later? So we can't actually look around this room. Can I get the shuttle? How do we get to the shuttle?
The bridge is damaged and currently inaccessible.
Bridge is damaged now? Sheesh. Oh, we can't get in that way.
The Cossacks have locked the door, Captain.
Sick bay and engineering.
If we want to fix these controls, we'll have to get into the Jeffries tube.
Captain, I know we want to prevent the alien from entering engineering, but from what we saw, I don't think a locked door will stop it.
Chekhov's right, Captain. And we don't want to restrict access to engineering in an emergency.
True that.
I don't like the looks of this hull integrity indicator.
Are we still the same with this stuff?
Atmosphere at 93.8, 24.1 degrees Celsius.
I think it's the same. I don't know what to do about the alien now.
Captain, is it too late?
Scotty, if we...
Actually, Captain. But Captain, the controls are working. But Captain. But Captain. But Captain.
But Captain, but Captain. I think... I don't know. How are we gonna get a scan of the alien? I guess we had one chance to do it, and now it's locked us out. Can we go down the hall this way? Just leaves us in the same place. Now, in the original game, if you went down the hall, you entered a different turbo lift, and you were able to get access to other areas. It doesn't seem to be the case here.
The bridge is damaged. And
we don't have time to waste. Kirk to Scott. Come in, Scotty.
Captain, the hull degradation is continuing. It's currently below 92%, but at the rate it's dropping, we have less than an hour before the ship is destroyed.
Kirk to Scott. Come in, Scott. Kirk to Uhura. Kirk to sickbay. Bones, where are you?
Jim, I'm waiting for that medical scan.
We're trying, we're trying.
Trying my patience, that is. McCoy out.
I've never had a doctor with Dr. McCoy's bedside manner before.
There are times when he's very good at motivating you to get as far away from him as possible.
Kirk to Scott. Kirk to sick computer. Kirk to sick bay. Bones, where are you? Kirk to Uhura. Come in, Lieutenant.
Captain, the rift is providing subspace interference. It's rather unusual. It's as though the interference were coming from subspace itself. I've never seen anything quite like it.
If Mr. Spock were here, he'd probably find it fascinating. Keep trying to break through and report anything else that's unusual to me. Kirk out.
That's right. There's a tube, not a tube, but a ventilation duct in there. But how do we get in there?
This panel doesn't seem to be working.
The alien has thought of everything.
We could bring down a phaser welder and force it open.
We don't have the time, Mr. Sulu.
Well, what if we weld it with our own gun or phaser?
Captain, the doors are programmed to automatically shut down if phasers are used on the controls. That won't work.
Hmm. Will they let us analyze things now? Oh, cool.
Nothing to report, Captain. The tricorder says the deck layout screen is correct. The tricorder doesn't pick up any malfunction with the monitoring system.
Hmm.
Captain, there's some sort of barriers on the walls and the doors. Our sensors cannot penetrate it.
Hmm, interesting.
The turbo lift monitor is functioning normally, Captain. No signs of damage to the monitoring systems. Nothing wrong with the turbo lift door, Captain.
Captain? I don't suppose I could scan this thing through the door.
Captain, there's some sort of barrier.
Kirk to Scott. Come in, Scotty. Kirk to Uhura. Kirk to Sick Bay. Computer.
Auxiliary control.
Auxiliary control. A secondary command room allowing control of basic functions of a starship in the event of damage to the ship's primary bridge.
Turbo lift.
Turbo lift. The principal means of high-speed conveyance within the confines of a starship. Passengers in a turbolift car can control the destination using spoken commands or a touch-sensitive directory display.
Jeffrey's tube. Nope. I wonder if we can get through the Jeffrey's tube. First we have to find the Jeffrey's tube, then we can get through that way, possibly. Can't go to the bridge. Engineering. The only thing I could think of is analyze everything. See if you find something that may be of use.
Nothing to report, Captain. The indicator is working fine, Captain.
Mm-hmm.
Everything in the communications panel checks out, Captain. Captain, there are no problems with the sick bay doors.
Don't use that tone of voice with me.
The sick bay life support warning system is working fine, Captain. Although I wish these Starfleet engineers could come up with shorter names for these systems.
It's a good thing Scotty's not here to hear you say that.
Haha. What is that thing?
Nothing to report, Captain. There's nothing wrong with the wall, Captain.
What is this? Is that a Jeffrey's tube?
There's nothing wrong with the floor, Captain.
Yeah, it's just a floor.
There's nothing wrong with this equipment, Captain.
Don't you have better things to do with your time than to examine my equipment?